Previously on Alan Wake, I wrote a horror story that has come true. Thomas Zane did the same in the 70s.
You will go no further.
If I continue like the Dark Presence wants me to, the story I'm writing won't save Alice. It's a horror story. No one will survive.
Oh, God.
Thomas Zane, you're the Lady of the Light in the song.
He left something behind to help me. The clicker.
Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
I can get to her now. I can finish this.
Episode 6, Departure. New York City, 2 years ago. So the story of the clicker he made up, it wasn't really his memory. It was like a memory that someone wrote in for him. So maybe it never happened at all, or it did happen, or this is all part of a story. Or... and he gave the clicker to Alice, but the clicker was there. Does that mean there's two clickers?
My head was about to explode.
Was it a fake clicker?
My eyes. I needed my sunglasses and painkillers to dull the pain. In one of my finer moments of self-deception, I swore to quit drinking.
Get sunglasses and painkillers. Pick up the sunglasses. Whoa, how
The sunglasses made the world look bearable. Now I could keep my eyes open without feeling like a vampire in the sun.
Getting the painkillers in the kitchen or something, or in the bathroom.
Get out there without some painkillers.
Looks like a blind guy.
Pills worked fast. The prospect of being awake started to seem bearable again. There was a message waiting for me on the machine.
It's Alice? Oh. Turn on the TV? Yeah, that's what I thought. Alice is not here. We have a sick place, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Harry Gallant Show.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. We have a great show tonight. I've been talking with the best-selling author, Alan Wake, about his new book, The Sudden Stop. Yeah, good read. Go buy it. No, it is a good read. Look, I'm going to be honest here.
Is that wise?
No, but I'm going to do it anyway. I got people who give me the lowdown on books. I'm a busy guy. But this one, I actually read from cover to cover. I mean, I'm a big fan.
Wow, thanks.
Now, this might be a spoiler for those who haven't read the book yet, based on the sales figures, the two people out there who haven't read the book yet. But this last book is all about the death of the main character, the hard-boiled New York detective, Alex Casey. Now, there's been a lot of outrage about this. Why the hell did you kill Casey? What the hell were you thinking, man?
Good riddance. No, seriously, though. 7 years and 6 books is a long time. He was a gloomy guy to spend all your working hours with, and it was a good run. But it's time to explore new things. My next book will be a departure from the old for me.
You selfish bastard, always thinking of yourself. You've certainly given us a lot of entertainment over the years. And now that you mention it, Casey was a gloomy guy. Never had much luck with his love life and the lady. Was that autobiographical in any way?
Yeah, no kidding. Casey's lady friends tended to die on him. With Casey, it was all about his pain. No, nothing autobiographical about that. I'm a happily married man. My wife is my muse.
Well, congratulations. That's great to hear. So, how's the publicity tour been treating you?
Good. Great. But I gotta say, I'm glad to be back home in New York.
Well, you've certainly been on the news a lot lately. Lots of parties and, you got into a fight with some paparazzi.
Oh, man. Well, that guy was really in my face. I lost my temper. I know that wasn't cool.
You are famous for that temper.
Well, I do. did also write several books? Well, your latest novel is called The Sudden Stop, and it's in bookstores now. Go get it. That means the two of you out there haven't bought it. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for tonight. I want to thank all our guests for the evening. Alan Wake, Sam Lake.
Sam Lake.
And our musical guests, Poets of the Fall. Thank you.
That was a pretty good show.
I told myself I could live with that.
Hey, honey. Did you watch the show?
I didn't say anything stupid, if that's what you want to know. Are you going to start with me about drinking now?
You know what?
Jeez.
Go back to sleep, Alan.
You're on edge, aren't you? Deadass.
What? Now you can't even talk to me?
Well, this morning I was angry because you said you'd be home at midnight and you showed up at 7 a.m. and passed out in mid-sentence. Now I'm over it. Are you angry?
This goddamn tour. It's gotten out of hand.
Oh, honey. It's almost over, right? We can get back to normal. And you can start writing again.
I'm sorry, honey.
Alan, you're not thinking straight. Just take a shower and go back to bed, huh?
Yeah, you're right, honey. I'm sorry. Once this is over, let's go away together. On vacation. Just you and me. Some peace and quiet.
Biggest mistake of your life. Biggest mistake of your life. Just keep partying, man. That's how you gotta do it. Brit Falls present day.
Somehow, the clicker was the key to the cabin. I had to return to Cauldron Lake to save Alice.
Doesn't do anything though, does it?
I'm going back to the lake to finish this. I'm going to write an ending to the story in the manuscript on my own terms, to make it all right.
Why can't you just write it here?
The last page is still in the typewriter. I need to read it first. Everything needs to be just right. Zane tried to cut some corners, and it didn't end well.
Okay, ready when you are.
I'm sorry, Sarah, but I need to do this alone. Barry, take her gun. Miss Weaver, close the door when I leave.
Aww.
Good luck, Al.
Christmas light, crazy motherfucker. Why you gotta make this so hard for yourself? Deadshot.
Got out. It was warm and sunny. I'd flipped the switch of the clicker. Had it done this? I didn't stop to question it. I had to take advantage of the sunlight to get to the lake. On Zane's page, I'd stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, about to use the clicker. That's where I was headed.
Please tell me it's gonna be sunny all the way there.
Alone, in daylight, surrounded by the beauty of the Pacific Northwest landscape, it was hard not to let doubt creep in one last time. I could still chalk everything up to a dream, a delusion. I had enough imagination to make up something like this, having been in the cabin all this time, trapped in a story inside my head, gone mad from grief over Alice's death like Hartman had claimed. There would be no way of knowing. I told myself it didn't really matter. My course was set.
It didn't really matter. Now I feel like I'm in like, oh my god, that handling. Holy shit. I feel like I'm in like GTA or something. Yeah, that's beautiful. Graphics, man. What's here? Nothing? Do I even have any gear on me? Probably not. This is kind of uneventful. What? Bullshit.
Again, getting closer.
Can't drive it.
Oh.
God damn. What? Reload really fast. Damn, these guys survive light pretty well. Well then. Manuscript. Dark Presence wants to stop Wake.
He was no longer trying to capture the writer so he could create the ending it wanted. The writer knew too much. He was too strong. And he carried a weapon left behind by Thomas Zane. Something that could hurt it. Now, the darkness was doing everything in its power to simply stop the writer from ever reaching Cauldron Lake and the dark place it came from.
Coming for you, bitch. Yeah, I knew that was gonna happen. Can I drive this thing? Yes. Press the clicker, make it come daytime again. There's no handbrake, is there? Man, there's so many cars. Boom! Surprise, cockbags! Bam! Well, I'm so going around. If there isn't a round. I want some ammo. Oh, there we go. Oh, so worth it to come here. What's this?
Based on the signature in the motel register, Agent Nightingale had stayed here, in room number 2. The poet and the muse. Lives by old gods.
So Nightingale stayed in like a little shitty motel.
An old tale wrought with mystery of Tom the poet and his muse, and a magic lake which gave a life to the words the poet used.
Really?
He knew she was his happiness, and he rhymed about her grace, and told her stories of treasures deep beneath the blackened waves, till in the stillness of one dawn, still in its misty crown, the muse she went down to the lake, and in the waves she drowned.
Ah, awesome. That was not depressing at all. Oh yeah, thermostat in the bathroom. You know, in the bathroom. Oh, whatever. Blah, blah, blah. I can't believe they even put that in the game. Revolver ammo. Examine.
This had obviously been the room where Agent Nightingale had stayed when he hadn't been busy harassing me.
When he hadn't been harassing me. But now you're dead!
Could have fooled me, pal.
Is there another room? Heyo! Go for the car! Oh yeah. Is that it? That was easy. Should I get a different car? Can't drive that one. Or that one. Well, anyway, I think this was pretty worth it to come here, so I'm gonna make my merry way now. Oh, shit. You know, that's a pretty sweet car. This car looks pretty sweet, too. Old school, man. Oh, there's a lot of light there. Holy sh- What the fu- Damn! Oh my god. Boom! The drifts. Boom! Have a seat. Okay, that was fun. Cars are so OP in this game. Can I drive this thing? I always wanted to drive a Mini Cooper. Ah, oh, my back's itchy! Okay, good. Holy crap. Oh, I thought that was like a box of ammo or something. That'd have been too good. Run away!
What the hell?
What the fuh? Oh my god. Oh my god, I almost got knocked off. Oh my god, I got clocked. Ah, so annoying. Super grenade is obviously not enough to take it out either. All right. I got you. I got this. I got it this time. Oh, man! Double kill. Oh, okay, never mind, got him. I was like, I didn't see two clicks. And then it starts throwing itself at me. I was like, oh, there it is. It's a drop! Yeah, there you go. Oh, is it? Oh, it's floating. Oh, there you go. It actually started floating. No way. Whoa. Yeah. Oh, there we go. Best case scenario. Oh, it's floating, but it's not gonna hit me. There you go. It's going pretty well. Holy shit. Woo! dodged. Where are you at? There you go. Okay, now obviously you have to dodge it. There's a way to dodge it, I guess. Let's try it out. Ow. What the fuh? I like how it blacked out to not show the animation of a crane dying. Wow. I made it look so easy that time. Other times I made it look like a freaking pain in the ass. Whoa, what the hell? Oh! Oh, splatter spree! Oh, what the hell? The hell? Is this a ghost car? Look at that, man. Can I squeeze through there? Nope. Oh, I totally have the right of way. Oh, what the hell is in here? Holy shit. That thing trashed my red. Oh, you got owned. Owned, sucker. I don't even care. I'm putting my batteries in. You're done. Done. Get out of here. I got a new ride. Is there friggin'? Is there stuff in here? Oh, please tell me there's stuff in here. Oh, hello. Manuscript page. Where is it? Oh, this one.
The poet in the news lyrics by old gods of Asgard, the second verse. The poet came down to the lake to call out to his dear. When there was no answer, he was overcome with fear. He searched in vain for his treasure lost, and too soon the night would fall. Only his own echo would wail back at his call. And when he swore to bring back his love by stories he'd create, nightmares shifted in their sleep in the darkness of the lake.
Dun da da! Some good music, man. Okay, well, time to drive this bitch. Ever had that, a ghost car? Ow. Looks like we're good. Oh, why so much shaky? What the hell? Oh my god. What the hell is that? A school bus? Holy shit! Oh, tire! Just run! Run! Huh. Made it. Can I squeeze it? Squeeze it! Come on! What the hell? I don't even know what I broke. Why are there always freaking? Oh. I was like, why are there always freaking, like, crashed cars, man? People don't know how to drive. Die. That's so funny how I still flipped that car over. That was great. Oh, and rest my battery. I like how quickly it recovers. If only actual flashlights were like this, could last forever. So, I don't get it. These are like darkness spots, but like, what happens if I actually step on them? Do I get damaged, or do I just slip and hurt myself? I just feel inclined to kill all of them. Uh-oh. Oh, yeah. Shit. Oh, hello. Oh. What? I died before the flashbang even went off. Fuck. God damn it. I gotta clear all this shit off again. Just cleaning the road, guys. My flashlight. Take that. That. And one of these. I don't know why I just consider it a lantern. I just call it like a heavy-duty flashlight. But I guess there already is a heavy-duty flashlight. Oh, what the hell? I didn't see these. Is there any benefit to killing those? Like, I don't see one. Oh, shit. You know, I got flares, dude. I got flares. Oh, shit. Ammo. Oh, my God. Ammo. Ow! Pick it up. Pick it up. Pick up flare, pick up shotgun ammo. Oh my god. You know what? Fuck all y'all. Oof. God damn, I don't even get a chance to freaking run. You know what? Fuck the slime. I'm not going through all that again. Fuck that. Wait, what happens if I jump on it? Oh! That's it? Oh, that's not even bad. Oh yeah. Get back, you don't know me like that. Sucker. Trial of the Dark Prince.
Was a graveyard of things the lake had claimed in one way or another over the decades. The Dark Presence brought them up in its wake, scattering the rotten waterlogged hull of an old boat here, the remains of a long ago crashed airplane there, trees shattered under the impacts. The earth groaned. It didn't even notice.
Man, it really does not want me to go back there to loot. Oh, whoa. I see a box. Please tell me I can open it. Thank God. Got no room for revolver ammo. Man, how many vehicles have I stolen throughout this play? Verizon, shout out. Sponsor. Okay. Detour is detour. Oopsies. Man, why you make a house if there'd be nothing in there? Ooh. Ow. Why do you have to punish me for doing this? All right.
I had to get the gate open.
Oh, well, that's cool. What's this? All visitors must see the yard manager. Whoa, shit! Whoa! Slow motion for no reason! Why are they following me? What bitches? Ow, fucker. Aw, yeah. Now leave me alone. God, for God's sake. Is this going to the same as the cache? Probably. Nothing there. Okay, hope the button's in here. Ooh, there's gear in here and a thermostat! Same batteries. Okay, I see a button. Is that it? Really? I hope that opened the gate. Flare gun manuscript page. Ooh.
The third verse. In the dead of night she came to him with darkness in her eyes, wearing a morning gown, sweet words as her disguise. He took her in without a word, for he saw his great mistake, and vowed them both to silence deep beneath the lake. Now, if it's real or just a dream, one mystery remains, for it is said on moonless nights that they may still haunt this place.
There's someone still walking around. Just where? Oh, hello. One! Oops! I used a flare gun. Didn't mean to. Oh, I thought I had a revolver out. Oopsies! Okay, I already checked here, right? Ooh, hunting rifle. Alright, I'm gonna take this car, it's in better condition. Oh, what the hell? Oh, time to get out of here. Jump! That was anticlimactic. the hell? Man, I got you damaged on everything. Jeez. Man, I am not a good driver. And a manuscript page is Thomas Zane's last sigh.
But it didn't die. The thing that wore Barbara's face kept crooning sweet nothings, sugar laced with poison. He put on the suit, untied the monster from the chair. The thing in his arms thrashed weakly, but he held fast. He stepped outside, off the pier, and into the dark water. A sinking pinprick of light descending toward a bottom that never came.
Oh, sacrifice. Am I almost there yet? Jeez, this trip is so... Why can't I just wait till the morning? Aw, yeah. The hell is that glass noise? No, there's a flash. I mean, there's a flare gun. No, stop. Why are you moving? Stop moving by yourself. Do what I say. Don't do what the game says. Come on, man. YOLO. What the fuh? You gotta be kidding me. Of course. The hell's it doing? Gotta blow all the batteries. Bam! To Shimon. Who the hell threw it? Who the hell threw that axe? Little bitch. Alright, we're driving through. Hell yeah. The hell? These things like show up as like something different, and then when I get close to them they like turn into like plants. Maybe I should have taken a different car. I'm pretty sure there's a different car just sitting right there waiting for me. This car's still in pretty good shape.
When I told Barry my plan back in the well-lit room, I'd acted as if I knew what I was doing. I didn't. I was operating on the shifting logic of a dream. I had to fight my way to the lake through the horrors of the night. I had to flick an old battered light switch imbued with childhood magic. I had to write a happy ending to a horror story. I had to save my wife from the dark prison she was being held in.
Push. God, I'm buff. Check that out. Yeah, you're tired and all, but it's worth it. What's this?
I will never give her to you.
Jesus Christ. Oh. Take this. Stupid chainsaw massacre Dumbledore douchebag. Crap. Reload. Holy crap, he took 12 shots already. My god. Wasting all the ammo. Okay, give me that, Dad. Thermoset. Pick up revolver. Hunting rifle. I keep forgetting it switches me to that weapon when I pick it up. It's really counterintuitive for me. Timber! For some reason, everyone stays still when I use this. It's great! It didn't kill him, did it? Ow. Oh my god! What the fuck? Like, they're so inconsistent, I hate it. They walk at first, and then they run just out of nowhere. They just start running like freaking madmen. And just like, can you please have the same behavior all the time? Click, click, click. All right. Sup? Cool. Okay, more flashbangs. Turn that on.
I will never give her to you.
That is so creepy. Oh, hey. Take it. Tease it. Okay. And snipe it. Bam. Hope you like that dirt. Okay, coffee thermos. No. I want to pick the bottom one. Hunting rifle. There you go. I got 5 bullets out of that. It's nice. Screw that, not wasting time. It's weird, it kind of switched shoulders on me. That was weird. Yeah, so he's just started running out of buttfuck nowhere. Another one bites the dust. Oh, he didn't die. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Shit. Oh, my God. Jesus Christ, man. You guys are nuts. Are you guys not killable? Is this it? Like, what? Oh shit, what am I hitting? Okay. Whoop. Get kited! Hop, 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 hop. Switching to my revolver. Damn, man. So like four revolver shots is equal to like one sniper bullet. Which is a hell of a lot. Nothing in here. Checking for the loots. Flare gun ammo. Pretty freaking sweet. Man, why did it have to show up out of the range of my light? Push! Push it, push it. Alright. Now where do I go? Manuscript. The dark place. The place I found myself in was unlike anything I could ever have imagined. It wasn't solid. It flowed. It was conceptual and subjective. For someone else, an artist in another field, it would have been very different. I could sense the story of the manuscript all around me. The words and ideas floating in the air, poised to become real. Real talks. Man, this pushing thing is so new. And they already did it to me 3 times in this level. Tally-ho! Oh, I'm not supposed to go down there. I didn't find any supplies in there. Ow! Owned. What did you think was gonna happen? Heal up, checkpoint it.
I could see Mirror Peak in the distance. That's where Cauldron Lake was.
Wow, I'm still this far? My God. I am a long ways away. I need them supplies. Flare gun ammo, flare gun ammo, pick up revolver. And I'm full on the revolver ammo. Okay. Yeah, get in. Get in, you dumb shit. Aw, man. Try again. Release the brake. Hey, it's like a roller coaster. Let's go. Wow, this is like the slowest roller coaster ever. Anyone ever been to Wonderland in Canada? It's like the Royal Canadian Mine Buster right here. Yeah, F you. Oh, see ya. Wouldn't wanna be ya. Checkpoint. Alright. Damn, I'm getting tired, dude. Let's go through here, it seems safe. Let's go through here. Where's that take me? This takes me nowhere. All intentional. All intentional. Now I'm gonna go for this supply crate and there's gonna be a lot of bad guys coming after me, but it's okay. Oh no, no one. Nice. Beauty. All these crows in the air makes me so scared. And slightly unaware of the creatures in the air while I shit my underwear. Oh, there's a ladder there. In the air. Oh boy. I can never kill them in one go. That just happened. Push! Heave! Ho, P90X muscles! I know you're a scrawny little bitch, but that's okay. Oh yeah, get owned. Stay away, stay away. Okay, bait them. Oh man, they didn't die. Okay, bait them again. And... see ya. Seems like a better strategy, just like, don't shine the light at them, so because they stay away if you do. And once they get really close, just like, burst them down. Oh my god. I'm afraid. Ooh. I have 16 flares, dude. I can flare you all night. Until my flares run out. Bam! Bam! Alright, enough of these stupid birds. Okay, I heard stuff. Oh, there you go. Whoa. Oh, I missed a lot of shots.
Boom! Boom! Easy. Easy, Bobeezy. Schnash. Kahizi. I almost like stepped at it before he killed it. I'm walking around, I'm like, man, I can't move. So much shit in the way, like, literally. Checkpoint. Oh, I thought that was stuff. Revolver, flare gun, lithium. Damn, I got 9 flare gun shots. I just cannot, there's no way I can die. Too many tools, man. Really? That jump hurt you? Fuck off. You wuss. Whoa. Heyo. Oh, hello. You little bitch. Oh my god, ow, ow! Why does this happen? Why do those guys not die? Like, the flashbang was like right on him. He just didn't die. Doesn't want to die. It's so inconsistent. Sometimes it like one-shots them and then sometimes it just doesn't. Like, how does that make any sense? Stay there. Didn't get you, probably. I actually thought I had a flare-up, but I guess not. Come on, come in. Yeah. A lot of shit here. Why are my frames dropping? Stop. Are you kidding me? Oh god, I keep opening up and dropping them. It's okay, I have a lot of flares. What the fuck? Running through might not be the best idea right now. Huh. Yo. Yo. Yo, hizzy, bo busy. Shus. Kneezy. See ya! Oh, I flashed by myself. Oh, Jesus Christ. Ah! Start it up. I wish I could like start it up while I hold like a flare or something, but that might make flares a bit OP. But I like The grenade strategy is working out pretty good. Whoa. Holy shit! My god. This girl is pissed. Oh! Just shit is literally falling from the sky. My god. Just run up the fucking stairs. Ow! Oh, there's fucking sludge. To the light! To the windows, to the walls! The sweat drips from my balls! Fire! The hell? Where's the box? Oh, here. Three flares, bad flashbangs. Great. I'm being stalked. The darkness something. Switch the pump action. Fuck that. Fuck that, motherpacker. Ammo box. Don't need anything. What does this box do?
I needed to get the generator running.
Where's the generator? Is it upstairs? Or is that the generator? Go! Huh! Huh! I don't like that chainsaw noise. Boom! Gonna kill him? Nope. Do it again. Ow! What the hell, man? I lit you. Holy shit, dude. How many bullets you take, man? Stupid fast guys. Oh, what the hell? Where'd you come from? Holy shit, you guys take a lot of bullets. He's just like running away. He wants no part of this. Checkpoint. Damn, son. I swear there's I hope there's an easier way to kill those guys. I just don't know what it is. Cause they're pretty hard. Sorry, that was my phone. Plug my phone in my computer. Get it charging again. Alright, now can we leave? Oh, manuscript page, yes.
After Zane had gone, I stood alone in the shifting dream that was the dark place. I had to find a way to the cabin. I'd written myself a way through this place in the manuscript. I followed the idea of a path. I'd written myself across the ocean that blocked my way, and with that, there was a bridge to the island beyond. The idea of the cabin flickered in the underwater darkness. I willed the cabin to be real, and it was.
Dun dun dun! This is the longest trip to this cabin ever. Developers of the game are like, yo, we need a filler for episode 6. Just make it the whole trip to the cabin. Turn back now. God damn, that's scary. Oh my god, ow! Oh my god, ow! Oh, fuck! I think I got plastered. I don't even have time to get out of it. Like, move! I just had all this shit hitting me. I guess reloading all my weapons before I get in there might have been a good idea. Okay, manuscript. We already read it. Turn back. Oh, I'm... Really? Really? Ow! Ow, my god! I have to break through all these? God damn it. Come on, come in. Ow! Oh, it shows me after they show up. Okay. I see the fairness in this game. Dickheads. Any more? Any more? Get out of my way. Who? Ow! No, you do as you're told. My story tells you everything. Nugget. I swear, if she had the power to do all this, like move all this stuff around, she could have like impaled me so easily. Liar! Oh god. My mind is in shambles. Oh! That could have been bad. Keep moving behind cover. Destroy the tornado. How do I destroy the are you kidding me? That's a hole. That has to be a dick. Ow. Something else hit me instead.
You can't win.
Huh. Huh.
You will fail.
Die! Die! Can't stop me, mofo! Oh, is that everything around it? Oh, nope. How about if I chuck a grenade? Oh, my battery's not recharging. Oh, shit. How the hell do I destroy this tornado? Do I have to destroy everything around it?
I had to get light into its heart to hurt it.
Oh! That makes sense. Lol. Huh! I can do it again, you know? Huh! Shout out to the pyro in TF2. Use that damn clicker. Make it wish it was real. And jump. And that's where he killed himself. Bad dream?
It was just another nightmare.
No.
Everything's fine. You're home.
It wasn't a dream. Everything's fine.
Oh my god.
Turn the lights on. Turn the lights on!
Shh, baby. The power's out. There's no light. Come back to bed and I'll make you forget all about your fear.
Hey, you're scared of the dark.
It's your fear. Why aren't you afraid? You're not Alice. Turn the lights on now. Where's the clicker? What did you do with it?
Alan, honey, you're still one foot in a dream. You're not making any sense. Come back to bed.
She'll make me forget about it, eh? Oh, I'm gonna find that clicker. Oh my god.
Alan, you're scaring me now. Come back to bed. Have you taken your pills? Do you want me to call Dr. Hartman? I read your manuscript. It's brilliant. Departure is your best work yet. You're a genius.
Oh my god, ow.
Out of you. Come back to bed. We'll talk more about it in the morning. Come back to bed, Alan.
Come back to bed, Tom.
Turn on the flashlight.
Tom.
Hey, there's the suit guy, Zane.
You must find your way to the tavern. It stands in your way. It won't let you pass.
Where am I?
It has no heart. It's filled with darkness. It must fill its heart with light.
How am I gonna fill its heart with light if it has no bloody heart? Hey, me. Pretty handsome.
Don't mind him. He's Mr. Your friends will meet him when you're gone.
When I'm gone? I'm getting a replacement?
Use the clicker.
Mr. Scratch. What's going on? My head. Telephone pole. So confused. Path, crate. It's like I'm in a program. Shopping cart. My flashlight. Oh, never mind. I thought I had like a limited thing. Make the telephone pole disappear. Whoa, hello. I hear typing. Am I typing all this in? Path. Okay, there's a lot of pointless shit then, if that's the case.
What?
I'm leaving you, Alan.
Oh, shoebox.
I'm in love with someone else.
Alice? No, what do you say? You can't.
You don't love me. You don't even love yourself. All you do is torture yourself with work you can't do anymore.
No, I love you more than anything in the world. You're my muse.
I'm not.
Who are
you? Oh.
What have you done with my Alice? It wasn't true. Nothing like that had ever happened.
You're not my Barbara.
Tom, let me go. I promised it would go.
Cabin.
Please, untie me, you naughty boy. I will help you reach your masterpiece. I will love it forever.
No, you're not Barbara Jagger. I made a terrible mistake. I should have never written you back. You came back wrong. Your heart is filled with darkness.
Put that knife away, Thomas.
Oh my god, he murdered him. Her.
Filled with darkness.
Get away from me, you hag! Where am I? Let me go!
Alice!
Get in there.
Now you will never get her back.
Oh, that's the hole where the heart was cut out.
I am much older than you.
Oh, so you're out of my league? Okay.
Older than your first work of art. I will find a new face to wear. Someone else to dream me free.
The power of love! Then I realized I ran out of oxygen and drowned myself. Now where is my wife?
I could feel Alice's presence close by. I understood what I had to do now. I knew how to write the ending to Departure. There's light and there's darkness. Cause and effect. There's guilt and there's atonement. But the scales always need to balance. Everything has a price. That's where Zane had gone wrong.
So this is all like the story of how Alan Wake overcame his writer's block.
Alice? Alice? Oh no!
Oh no! Is he rewinding? What is he doing? Can't tell if it's going backwards or forwards. Hey, she's swimming. Did he sacrifice himself for her? That's Deerfest going on. Who the hell is that? That wasn't Sarah. They're the Asengard guys. That creepy chick, the smile. I don't know who that guy was. I don't get it. What is it being an ocean have? What? My head. I don't feel satisfied because I don't understand. Now I have to go look it up. Man, that was confusing. Yeah, I'm gonna go look that up, but I'm gonna let the credits run, because I believe in credits running. Giving credit when I can. There are always exceptions, but, I'm gonna go brush my teeth or something, go jack off, you know, their usual. Enjoy your day, guys. Thanks for watching me. Hopefully you join me for the next Let's Play. I'll catch you guys later. These credits take forever. Anyway. I don't know if it's done yet. I really want to eat this food in front of me. And I want to watch like a video or something. So, credits get done! Oh, there we go. Awesome! Thanks for watching, guys. Take care. Peace!